So while Cara's working on this hazer unit, I thought it'd be quite interesting to take a look inside. So this device is designed to put out quite a strong airflow, and it injects haze into it, which is basically like a smoke machine, but it does it a much more sort of refined output, and it just creates a general haze in the air instead of just blowing out clouds of smoke. So what actually happens here is there's a pump here that pumps liquid in from the reservoir tank, but that then gets combined with air, and there's an air pump here, and the air intake is up here. Then the output of the air tank actually loops in around the control circuitry, not because it's actually doing anything in there. I think it's just purely just to sort of act as a sort of trap to stop liquid going back up the tube. And that air then comes down and gets combined with the... Oh, that's my meter. Breathing, that's all right. I've left the meter on. So the air comes down and gets combined with the liquid that's coming through, the haze liquid, and then goes into this heater coil here, which is basically a heated rod with a coil of presumably copper pipe wrapped around it. I'm not sure if that's copper. Might be steel. And it, for temperature control, has a thermocouple bonded onto it, which goes back up to the electronic control system. And we've basically got a power supply and the control system here, plus Cara's just taken off the remote control board with the buttons and display. I'm not sure if that contains a processor as well. It might actually contain some of the processing circuitry, but it's been quirky. That's why Cara's taken that out to have a look and see if it's the problem. The other thing you can control in here from DMX is the speed of the fan. And initially I thought this was a power supply for the unit here, but it actually says 437 millihenries, 0.3 amps. I'm guessing maybe it's just a large choke in series of the fan, just for suppression because it's being phase angle controlled. And that's fundamental. There's a lot less in sound as I was expecting. I also expected thermal insulation around these, as you often find in the haze and smoke machines. But it's actually surprisingly empty for what I was expecting. But it's quite interesting the way they combine the air with the fluid before pumping it in here. Presumably just to sort of spread the liquid about more as it goes through the heater block. It's quite odd. But yeah, interesting.